you for coming. This is a rescheduled day, obviously. I told everybody, but they've chosen not to come. But here's the attendance sheet. You'll get some credit for attending. Today, as we were going to last week, I want to discuss the theme about social construction. Social construction is one of the five different theories that this short class is covering. So far, let's talk about the five theories in general to show where we are today. First of all, we talked about forms of neo-Malthusianism. This is the idea that environmentalism and the environment is analyzed mostly as an issue of population, population control, population management, and the assumption that population is the variable causing environmental problems. This, of course, as some would say, is a social construction. This is one of many interpretations about the environment. And most sociologists would argue that the population is not a direct variable of environmental problems. Despite the media constructing this, despite many institutions globally talking about population control as an environmental issue, typically this, I think, can be profitably analyzed as a social construction, because many other ways the world destroys the environment, regardless of population. For example, many countries have very small populations, but they have a lot of direct influence upon the environment. United States, 300 million people, but it's has a huge portion of the consumption and use of raw materials in the world. So a direct idea of population would be that population would be a direct measure of raw material use, but that's not true. The distribution matters. So that's a good example and critique of neo-Malthusianism. Second, we also talk about eco-Marxism. Eco-Marxism is the idea that the construct, that capitalism is the major destroyer of the environment. And then third, we talked about another construct of ecological modernization, that there are many technologies and ideas, meaning that we could grow with the environment and not see capitalism as innately destructive. It's just our particular choices of materials and technologies are destructive. And since the 1970s and 80s, people have critiqued eco-Marxism with the idea of ecological modernization. Then, number four, we're talking about social constructionism, beginning in the 1980s across the global academy, particularly in sociology. People began to argue the environment is real, but it's also a social construct. For instance, acid rain, acidic rain, has been known for over 150 years, but it wasn't constructed as a problem until the 1970s and 80s. I mean, physically it has existed, but materially, immaterially it has existed, but socially it has not existed. Think about social movements for the environment. Do social movements around the world always talk about the environment with the same ideas? No. In the United States, people talk about the environment and they might use a Native American. Do Koreans use the Native American as a symbol of the environment? No. Most likely, Koreans would use maybe a Buddhist symbolism of the interpenetration of humans and nature in balance. So you can look exclusively at the social construct of the environment. One of the persons who organized and constructed the modern environmental movement is Rachel Carson, writing her book Silent Spring in the 1960s, 1962, 1963. And this, without her, would not have been a major media issue. Materially, it would still exist as a problem, but no one was talking about it. In her book, she describes a context where people in government, in industry, we're privately talking about this, but no one was brave enough to construct this idea in the public media. So this is how we can analyze another level of environmental sociology. This is the fourth level, or social construction. Here's an example from Korea. This is called and being constructed as a restoration project. This is the construction of dams and weirs and dredging in the rivers of Korea in these four areas. It's conducted 24 hours a day for the past 2 years. 17 workers have died. Much of the construction is actually very bad and falls apart because they're working too fast. And there's lots of corruption involved in it. But the media is almost completely cleansed, completely cleaned of any critiques of this project. Originally, this was called a Grand Canal. And Koreans did not like this project as the Grand Canal. So, what did the government do? It promised it would stop the project. But, instead, I argue, the project has continued under a different name. It's called the Four Rivers Construction. I wrote an editorial arguing that these two projects are very similar. This is at the Korea Times. I saved a copy. So this is an example of social construction. I wrote in 2009, New Green Deal, this is what the current president is constructing. He's building more nuclear power, he's dredging the rivers, but it's being constructed as a green policy. And what I did was analyze the previous Grand Canal and the Four Rivers reconstruction. And I noted there is no difference. There's empirically no difference, but they're talking as if it's a different project, but it's not change. So that's one way to analyze social construction. So who uses social construction? Let me show you one more thing. We can think about social construction in many ways. The examples today, there are three that we'll look at. One would be cultural construction of the environment in general. Different societies talk about and experience the environment in their minds very differently. Think about a Native American versus someone who is a stockbroker working in Seoul. They would have a different social analysis of what a mountain is. A mountain might be a spirit guide for a Native American. But a mountain, for another person, might be a lot of money waiting to be mined. And I have a PowerPoint that will look at Easter Island. Easter Island has been constructed by many different people to try to justify their theories about environmental problems. Another example, we can see empirical data because different social movements construct the environment in different ways. Different states will construct the environment in different ways. In Korea, you have a huge conflict between different social movements constructing the environment and the state. Within this, I will talk about environmental racism. This means people of lower socioeconomic status, they typically experience the worst environments materially, but most people ignore that until it's been described as racism. A third area is different subjective views about the environment. There's an interesting article, a suggested reading in our packet, of subjective appraisal of risk and your position in society. People who have more powerful positions in society tend to neglect the issues of risk. People in less powerful positions tend to magnify their construction of risk. So this is what I will